Hey everybody, it's Brittany here with Meaningful Kids, and today we're going to be doing, I guess you could say a tutorial or maybe a look and learn. I'll just be sharing with you all how I achieve my braided ponytails. And the model that we have here today is Naya. So say hey, Naya. Say hey, girl. Okay, y'all, so you all will be seeing a lot of Naya currently right now. We're actually working on growing her hair back. Her hair, it did come out around these areas. It's actually growing back. I will insert some pictures, maybe like right here on this clip or maybe at the end of the video. But if you take a look at her hair, you can also see that she is getting results with using our hair care line. If you all didn't know, we have our own deep conditioning, our own deep cleansing shampoo. We have our moisturizing shampoo, and we also have our hydrating conditioner, and we have our moisturizing grease as well that really does get the job done when it comes down to growing any type of alopecia areas back or any type of like balding or thinning that you having, or even if you having any type of like skin issues as far as like eczema or psoriasis, our grease is also good for that. But just to get us started, the brand that I like to use, especially for my kids, when it comes down to the braiding hair, because we are gonna be adding hair for length, and we're also gonna be adding it so that she can get curls on the end. But the brand that I like to use is called Rua. I'll put a link in the description box so you all will be able to order the hair offline as well. If you all like how the style comes out, this is a really good brand, because this brand, it blends in with mostly everybody's hair, and it's also really good for like someone that does have thinning hair. So like say for instance, like if your client has maybe like a bald spot, or maybe, you know, like the hair isn't long enough to be able to like catch through the whole braid, this will be the perfect type of brand to use. And it's also good for kids as well, because it's not that long and you'll still get that look that you want. It'll still be a full neat look, and you know, and it still won't be like too boxy. Like, you know how sometimes like once you get done dipping the hair, you may like cut it, like, and sometimes like if you cut it the wrong way, it may end up too boxy, and once it dries, it just don't look that good. This brand, you won't get those type of results with this brand. So you can just take that into consideration, and I will be sharing the products that I'll be using to achieve this style as well. As you can see, her hair, it is, you know, she's natural, whatever, but you know, in order to get a longer lasting style, her mom already shampooed her hair, so I'll just be blow drying it. But I'm also going to be using some heat protectant, and my favorite heat protectant to use is by Design Essentials. You all can find it at y'all local beauty supply store, or I can put a link below so you all can get y'all some. But I love to use their heat protectant. Another old school shining gem I also be using, this is really good to use product whenever you are braiding, because it's just better, it makes your style looks better, and it helps it to last longer, give it a longer hold. The next product that I'll be using is some gel. It's called Lock In. This is a pretty good product. It's good for braids. It's good for locks. It's good for edge control. It's good for, you know, like if you want to do like any type of molding style, like maybe a ponytail or like some feed in braids or something, like these are really good for that. And the next, honestly, this will be my first day using this, but I've seen this, the Shining Gem. They have their own mousse now. They say it's for braids. So we're actually going to see how this product works as well. And what a lot of people, or what a lot of stylists or braiders don't tell you, is that a lot of your styles may not be lasting long because no one is allowing the style to set anymore. Like, they're not making their clients like sit up under the dryer. So what I'm gonna do with this is, once I finish the whole look, I'm gonna put this on her hair, and I'm gonna sit her up under the dryer, and we're just gonna see, you know, like the difference that it'll make on the hair. And of course, we have to use our grease, our product right here. You see, this is our moisturizing grease. I don't know if you all can see it, but this is what it off, and this is what it looks like. It's all natural. And our grease has coconut, rosemary, lemongrass, and patchouli in it. And if you didn't know, like, all of those ingredients, you can go research it yourself. You don't have to take my word for it, but it's really good for the dryness in the scalp. It's good for putting the moisture back into the hair cuticle, and the patchouli is also good when it comes to hair growth because it helps to stimulate the brain and speeds up the growth process. Okay, but that is what we're getting started with. So it's gonna be like a clip type thing, but I don't know. Once I figure this edited thing out, you all will see. You can go ahead and watch whatever you're gonna watch because we like to start. Okay. So normally, what I like to do first, you know, if they told me that their mom already did their hair, already shampooed their hair, I still go through the scalp. You know, and I check the scalp just to make sure, you know, they didn't miss any spots, or to make sure there's not no sores or bleeding or any balding, and to also check to make sure that the spots that we were working on, they're actually growing. So let me turn her around so y'all can actually see. Okay, so now you can't turn your head this way. So maybe like a couple of months ago, we were dealing with this spot. Like all of this was gone. Like I said, I'm gonna put some pictures. But as you guys can see, she got a little peach fuzz right there, and it's actually growing back thanks to our products. If you all wanna purchase our products, you can shop online. The description is, not the description. The link is actually in the description. So as you can see, her hair, it is growing back on this side. And also, this side has started to break a little bit. But it's all growing back, see? So if you are wondering if our products work, they do work. They do work. You just gotta trust the process and understand that healthy hair, it does take time, okay? So. Yeah, so we're gonna go on to the next clip. So this is the before, and then like I said, I'm gonna use the heat protectant, we're gonna blow dry it, and then I'm gonna come back and show you all how I section the hair off in order to get a ponytail, or just to make it go by a whole lot faster. Alrighty guys, so we're back. We blow dry her hair, and I actually sectioned her hair off. So she's actually gonna have like a little bang piece or like two braids hanging from right here. So we already sectioned this part off. And as you can see, the easiest way to do one ponytail is to go ahead, hold your head down please, to just go ahead and section the hair into four ponytails. It doesn't matter if the parts are clean or not, you can always go back and clean up the parts as you go. But the easiest way to do it is to just go ahead and section the hair into four different sections. And before I like speed up the process or like skip some processes, I'm gonna show you all how I braid and how like I use the product as I braid as well. Okay. So because we don't want that braid to fall directly into her face, we actually made this more of a curved part. So the braid can actually land right here and fall down this way versus falling into her face to where it'll be in her eye. Okay. So we part down. So first what I do is I go ahead and I part the hair in the direction that I want the braid to go. And then I'll get some shining gem. And I'll put it over the part so I can go and clean the part up. Comb the hair back on each side of the part. Comb the hair back. Journey, please stop.
That's Juwan.
Juwan, please stop. Okay, so you see how I got the braid coming all the way down right here? To make sure that it's gonna fall how it needs to fall. Okay. So comb that back. Now we left with this part. So to make sure that your client hair doesn't get tangled or matted when it is time to take the braids out or while you're braiding it so it doesn't hurt, make sure that you comb through the hair properly. And what I like to do to give it a longer hold, I put some more shiny gem. I put some on this side because there's already some on the other side. Put a little bit on this side, comb it through. Then I like to get my lock in. A little bit will take you a long way, so you really only need a little bit, especially when you're doing a child's hair, because this product is so thick. Sometimes you can hurt the child with this locking gem because it's so thick and it dries really fast. So with it drying really fast, you know, the hair gets stuck together, and then that'll cause your hair the hair to get stuck to your fingers, and you know that the child is moving, then it's gonna cause products. You know, it's just so much. So you just gotta be careful. And then of course you wanna get your grease. Meaningful Kids moisturizing grease. And you want to grease the scalp. Comb that back. You could use clips if you want to, or you can use the comb to keep this part back. But normally, if you comb it back with the product still on it as you parting this hair, it really won't go nowhere. So let's start the braid, and then I'm gonna also show y'all like where I feed in the braid as well for length. But most of the hair is gonna be her own hair. Need a little tiny little piece of hair. We're gonna add a tiny little piece of braid in here. So about this much. And just feed it in. Tiny piece. And then just feed it in. And it's good to feed the hair in throughout the braid because that'll also give you a longer lasting braid as well. And the good part about it too is that you really won't be able to see where the hair was added. So because we're getting to the ends, I'm gonna add another piece of braid in here. So this is where we'll be adding it for the length so that the end of the braid can be full. You always want to make sure that you have a full braid just to make sure that your hair, your style has some type of body or volume to it. Okay. and I like to add hair little by little just to keep it a natural look because they are kids. And you know, like for the hair that's still like natural, that's like curly or puffy, you can either get some lock in or you can get some shining gem and just add it to the ends, just rub it across the ends like how I just did and smooth it out. You can get your comb it out and smooth it out some more, and then you can just keep braiding. And this is just going to ensure that you have a clean braid on the ends and no flyaways will be popping out of the braid or no curly ends. And as you can see, you can't even tell that I added some hair. Well, we just gonna braid this all the way down to the end. And we normally don't do her braids like too long. So we're actually gonna braid this down to chin length. And the easiest way to keep up with your braids, like as you braid, we're gonna curl the end, so we're gonna put rollers on the end. You're just gonna tie a knot. So you're just gonna grab one little piece of hair like this. I don't know if y'all can see, but just a tiny piece. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna hold this, the braid in your hand like this. You got this tiny piece. You're gonna pull this, the tiny piece, under, and then you're gonna use your middle finger, and then you're gonna tie it in the knot like that. Tie it in the knot. You still got this, we gonna wrap it around. You're gonna pull this through the circle like this. I hope y'all can see. Pull it through. Slide it up and dangle your knot. Let me turn it closer. So you got this. Wrap around. Put it in a circle. Tie up. Dangle your knot. Okay. So I'm gonna do the second braid, and then I'm gonna show y'all one more trick, and then I'm gonna finish our hair up and show you all the finished product. And you see how I can still go in right here and clean this up. Okay. So there you go, we'll see you next one.
Ow!
All right, so now that we're done with the bang part, we're actually gonna go ahead and start the ponytail. So the easiest way for like me to do the ponytail is to go ahead and section the braids off or part the braids off inside of each section. So that way I won't have to stop throughout doing it. And that way I already have four braids sectioned off, okay? Which saves a whole lot of time. So we already know that we want the ponytail to be right here in the center. So the easiest way to do it is to just part the braids in the direction that you want the braids to go in. So of course we want this braid in this section to come up this way. So the easiest way for me to do it, I like to part diagonal or slanted. So the comb will go like this instead of straight. We don't want the braid to go like this. We want the braid to come up like this. So we're going to part down. So come up like this. And this is the shiny gem on her hair. So this we're going to use to clean up the part. Her scalp is kind of sensitive. So, yeah. And this is... the section where it was some damaged hair on this side, but you okay, Naya? But it's growing back. Do the comb hurt? No. Okay. All right. So yeah, so that's how I go in and clean it up. And this is actually one braid. And the reason why I said don't worry about the other part is because you can always go back and clean them up. Now, I know some people like to use clips. I like to use rubber bands and bows only because I'm dealing with kids and it's so easy for them to knock the clips out their head or to be moving around or for it to snag. I still do use the clips from time to time, but I prefer rubber bands and, you know, the hair scrunchies. So now, because this part was also broken off right here, as y'all can see, this little piece, I have to make sure that this part is precise and clean. So I just put some shiny jam on that side, and I had to go in and I had to clean this part up. Had to be really, really detailed with how I clean this part up. Just to ensure that, you know, the style comes out how it's supposed to come out, and to ensure that the style lasts how we need it to last, okay? So, because the damage is on this part, I'm gonna wait to part the section in the back so I can go ahead and do the braid in the front. But what I will do is I will go ahead and show you all the other sides. I don't even know if y'all will be able to see it, but that's just what I'm gonna do on each side because it's actually too much to show y'all on each side. So I'm gonna do it on the other two sides and then I'll come back and show y'all when it's done. But that's just, you know, a way for y'all to do it.
So bury me past the fire. Until the
Okay, y'all, so y'all can see the finished product. We decided to do We decided to do a bun instead of a regular ponytail. So this is just me spinning her around. And we're going to go ahead and use some of this. The magic fingers mousse. Supposed to be satin mousse. I'm actually scared to put some on her natural hair, so I'm going to just put some on the bun part. Because, like, normally when I put stuff, like, wet stuff on her natural hair, that's why it's very good to pay attention and to learn your client's hair as well, so you can know what products to use and what products to not use on their hair. But I'm going to just use some, like, on the bun area. And like on her edge, because I don't want to take no chances with her hair, because we do want this style to last. And to curl her hair, we're actually going to use the blue rollers, because we want the curl to last, and we want it to be like a little tight. So at least if the curl is really, really tight, at least if it's originally tight, once it falls, it normally holds up for the duration of the style. Sorry. And one way to curl the ends of the hair, since it's two braids, to make sure that the braid is even. Like, this is what I normally like to do. I'm going to push her back a little bit so y'all can see. I like to start at the bottom of the braid, so you see like where the knot is. So I place the roller like this. I hold it like this, and I the bottom of the braid, so it'll be like this. And then I twist and wrap like this from the top to the bottom. So just keep twisting like this. And this will give it more of like a corkscrew type curl. And then she's just gonna sit up in the dryer maybe for like 5 or 10 minutes with it on low. Just to give, you know, it some time for the lock in, the shining gem, and the mousse to sit in, which is already sitting in as we speak. But yeah. So that's all I wanted to show y'all, how I do my curls, and to show y'all like how I was gonna use the mousse as well.
Wow. Very pretty, mommy.
Right, so she's gonna go sit up in the dryer and we'll be back with the finished product. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. Follow us on Instagram, follow us on TikTok, and follow us on Facebook. And don't forget to shop our online shop as well. Thank you again. Goodbye. Cheese.